The Advanced Land Observing Satellite, called ALOS, completed its 5-year mission in May 2011. Data acquired by ALOS has been used in many fields for the benefit of society. And now, the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA, has developed a new advanced land observing satellite, the ALOS-2. ALOS-2 is designed to conduct disaster monitoring in emergencies, to obtain land use information, and to contribute to reducing global warming through its observation of forests around the world. ALOS-2 carries the L-band synthetic aperture radar system called Pulsar-2 with enhanced performance capabilities. In response to society's ever-changing needs, ALOS-2 will realize faster, broader, and more detailed land observations all over the world. The earthquake and tsunami that struck northern Japan on March 11, 2011 caused tremendous damage. ALOS conducted many observations of the affected areas. These images were captured by ALOS on March 15th. They showed the extensive flooding caused by the tsunami. The red portions are the flooded areas, which kept changing day by day. ALOS continued to monitor these changes. In all, ALOS observed 315 major disasters in different parts of the world. JAXA made the data available in Japan and other countries. It took ALOS up to 3 days to observe any part of the world. ALOS-2 can shorten this time and observe a target area in Japan within about 12 hours and other Asian regions within about 24 hours. If required in an emergency, ALOS-2 will provide data to the Japanese government, local governments, and other relevant organizations as quickly as 1 hour after its observations. The Pulsar-2 system on ALOS-2 can observe land surfaces through cloud cover and even in inclement weather. ALOS captured images in September 2008 following heavy rains in Gifu Prefecture, Japan. The analyzed results are shown in blue, indicating the areas assumed to be covered by floodwaters. Observations from space make it possible to understand disaster conditions in the affected area. This helps in planning effective ways to rescue and evacuate people, preventing secondary hazards, and supporting rapid recovery efforts. The Pulsar-2 radar system will also observe volcanoes. When Japan's Shimoidake volcano erupted in 2011, ALOS responded with emergency observations of the affected areas. Regarding the situation at the time of the eruption, we talked with the Japan Meteorological Agency's Jun Funosaki. Our agency's main job is to release weather forecasts, but we also have a system to monitor volcanoes 24 hours a day. Whenever there's a change in observed volcano data, or if an eruption is predicted, we issue warnings and information to prevent or mitigate damage from the disaster. A small eruption began on Shimoidake volcano on January 19, 2011, and toward the end of the month, the activity increased, with lava appearing inside the crater. A lava dome developed inside the crater at the summit, and we knew that if it expanded more, a dangerous pyroclastic flow could occur. Huge quantities of volcanic ash were released from the lava dome, so conditions couldn't be observed from an airplane. But JAXA's ALOS satellite could observe the lava dome through the ash, so we learned that the dome had expanded to a diameter of about 500 meters. This fact was included in the warning from the Japan Meteorological Agency. When volcanic activity increases, it's difficult to know what's happening inside the crater. The same problem arises at nighttime and during bad weather. but those conditions don't interfere with images taken by the synthetic aperture radar system. And by improving resolution capability and increasing image taken frequency, we hope to get more details on crustal deformations regularly. Japan has volcanoes in many parts of the country. ALOS-2 can observe conditions regularly over a wide area, so it'll be very useful in observing volcanic activity in Japan. The Pulsar-2 radar system is effective in capturing crustal changes caused by an earthquake or volcanic activity. Its observations make it possible to continually obtain data over wide areas and to detect crustal deformations as small as a few centimeters. The Geospatial Information Authority of Japan is part of the Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport. Dr. Tomokazu Kobayashi explains how they used ALOS data. Our Crustal Deformation Research Division has two main purposes. One is to monitor surface movements resulting from seismic or volcanic activity. The other is to try to understand what is happening under the ground using observation data. We used two sets of data observed at the same place at different times to understand in detail how much a specific ground surface has moved. For example, we used ALOS data to learn when magma under the ground was pushing upward and causing changes in the ground surface. Then we depicted those areas in different colors to show the extent of ground surface movement. One thing we expect from ALOS-2 is the ability to perform observations rapidly. After the 2011 megaquake and tsunami, ALOS took about 1 month to obtain a complete data set for ground surface condition study. But ALOS-2 should be able to give us the same amount of information in a few days when it uses the mode observing over a wide area. Another thing we expect from ALOS-2 is improved spatial resolution. That will help us understand in greater detail any major movement on the Earth's surface caused by an inland quake or volcanic activity. ALOS-2 will also contribute to disaster monitoring in other parts of the world. In 2010, ALOS captured images after heavy flooding in Pakistan. They were made available upon the request of the International Charter on Space and Major Disasters and Sentinel Asia, international collaborative frameworks for sharing satellite data with other countries during a disaster. And under this international cooperation, other space institutes provided Japan with their Earth observation satellite data after the 2011 Great East Japan earthquake. ALOS-2 will conduct observations on a daily basis, not only for disaster monitoring, but also for the ever-changing needs of society. For example, it will continually monitor the global forest cover to help tackle serious environmental problems like global warming. Southeast Asia and South America are deforestation hotspots. ALOS-2 will continually monitor these areas. The Pulsar-2 radar system on board uses long L-band radio waves, which are suitable for monitoring forests. This will allow observation of changes in forest cover and biomass volumes over time. The Global Environment Department of JICA, the Japan International Cooperation Agency, relies on data from ALOS. Takuya Sekiguchi explains. JICA implements Japan's international cooperation initiatives. Our collaboration with other countries extends over a great many sectors, from development of transportation and road infrastructure to education, public health, sanitation, poverty reduction, and environmental protection. ALOS data is used in our forest projects. One good example is a project in Brazil. Much of Brazil's Amazon region is covered by clouds for about half the time each year. So the problem had been to obtain data by optical satellites used by the Brazilian government during that cloudy season. But Pulsar could monitor forested areas through the clouds, so it could provide a solution to their problem. The Brazilian government told its people that ALOS was monitoring them to check for illegal cutting. People realized they were being observed from above. We've been told this was extremely effective in preventing unlawful logging. It seems to have raised awareness. The features offered by ALOS-2 will be superior to ALOS, so we expect it'll be able to monitor illegal logging in close to real time. While orbiting, ALOS-2 will continually observe land surfaces over a wide area. That data will be archived to be used for national land conservation and management. For national food security, data contributing to the food production forecast is very important. To assess rice supplies, ALOS-2 data will be used to compare images taken before and after new planting and during the growing season, while taking into account existing geographical information. In this way, it will be possible to identify the partitioning of rice fields and to calculate the cultivated area. This technology can be applied in Southeast Asia as well, where rice is also grown. JAXA has a plan to use ALOS-2 data to enhance information on current rice cultivation in Asia. Sea ice is a big tourist attraction in northern Japan every winter, but it hinders ship navigation and can even cause a major accident. The Japan Coast Guard provides information on sea ice every day during the winter using data from aircraft and patrol boats. But that information is difficult to obtain during bad weather and on cloudy days. ALOS-2 will collect data on sea ice even on cloudy or snowy days. Its observation data over the Sea of Okhotsk will allow the Japan Coast Guard to quickly produce daily sea ice charts. These charts will help prevent accidents at sea. ALOS-2 weighs about 2 tons. It will be launched aboard an H-2A rocket. After ALOS-2 separates from the rocket, it deploys solar array paddles measuring about 16.5 meters in length. The paddles convert sunlight into electric energy and supply it to the satellite. Then the Pulsar 2 L-band synthetic aperture radar antenna is deployed. The 10-meter-long antenna transmits radio waves toward the Earth's surface and captures them when they bounce back. Finally, the X-band antenna is deployed to the left and right of the satellite. It transmits observed data to ground stations. The original ALOS's transmission rate was 120 megabits per second, but the rate for ALOS-2 is 800 megabits per second, almost 6 times faster. Even when data can't be sent directly to the ground stations, it can be transmitted to them via Japan's data relay satellite Kodama, which is in geostationary orbit. ALOS-2 orbits the Earth at an altitude of about 628 kilometers, taking a polar orbit to pass over the North and South Poles. Its revisit time, the time it takes to return above the same point, is 14 days. Compared with a revisit time of 46 days by its predecessor, the ALOS-2 makes more frequent observations of the same locations. The synthetic aperture radar system is deployed at an angle under the satellite. ALOS-2's look direction was to the right only, whereas ALOS-2 is able to tilt its attitude for left and right looking capability. And the observable area is nearly triple, from 870 to 2,320 kilometers. ALOS-2 has different observation modes for different observation requests. Spotlight mode offers the highest spatial resolution. In this mode, the antenna continually transmits radio waves to a target to be observed. Observations have a spatial resolution of 1 to 3 meters. This makes it possible to observe areas in detail and to learn about conditions after a disaster. Strip map mode is the basic high-resolution observation mode. To detect changes in the Earth's surface, it's necessary to compare an area before and after the change so the satellite can acquire and accumulate globally consistent land surface data. In strip map mode, the spatial resolution can be set at 3, 6, or 10 meters. ScanSAR mode offers the widest field of observation with spatial resolution of 100 meters, which, though not very precise, allows observations over areas up to 490 kilometers wide. This will be useful in frequent monitoring of the Amazon tropical rainforest and the extent of sea ice on the Sea of Ohotsk, among other locations. When I was involved in the development of the ALOS satellite, I talked with the people and organizations that would use its data. We want to make ALOS-2 even more effective, and I've kept this in mind while talking with future users. What makes ALOS-2 special is that, compared with ALOS, it'll give us faster, more detailed observations over broader areas. Observing changes on Earth from space will lead to a better future for people on this planet. The Advanced Land Observing Satellite, ALOS-2, will make this possible.